Hey everybody, welcome back to another video. If you're new here, my name is Misha and I make videos all about sustainability and vegan lifestyle. And today I'm gonna go over how I'm going to plan out through the holidays, gift giving and gift receiving. So stay tuned. Okay, so I know how sometimes it can be a little taboo to talk about asking for gifts or requesting gifts, but I know that that's pretty traditional in some families, so I definitely want to mention that. But I'm going to start out talking about gift giving. So I'm going to go through my top 5 to 8 tips and tell you exactly how I'm going to go about it. This is the first real holiday that I have this as a forefront in my mind, so if you have anything that you want to add in, please feel free to leave it in the comments below and we can all help each other out. So a little bit about my family. A lot of times closer to the holidays, there will be either a text sent out or some type of request asking what you would like for Christmas this year. So if I get a text request, I want to have a list ready just in case that is the case. Now, I'm not requesting gifts, but I just know that that's probably going to be coming. So I want to be prepared in case that is the case. There comes a time where there's a little bit of an in-between. You don't necessarily want to obviously reach out first and say, this is what I'm expecting or this is what I would like for Christmas. But you want to be prepared because you don't necessarily want to get a gift, obviously, that you don't want or you won't need because that's not sustainable at all. So if you have a couple things in mind, that could be really helpful. So that's why I'm putting out this video now, because then by the time when the holidays come around, or hopefully, you know, if you are one of those people that gets really early requests or go shopping really early, then you can plan ahead that way too. Okay, so as far as tips go, and what I've been doing this time around, is there are certain family members or friends that you're going to be getting gifts for that you will probably already know if they will accept secondhand items or not. But if you aren't sure, then that's always a good thing to ask when you are asking, you know, is there something that you need or something that you would want for this holiday? I know that my parents don't really mind secondhand gifts. They'll actually sometimes request secondhand gifts, especially in my dad's case, for example, last winter, he goes through books pretty often, so he doesn't mind getting secondhand or used books. There's other family members that I know absolutely do not like secondhand gifts, so that's perfectly fine. But asking if that's a possible thing would be great, because then obviously that's the most sustainable way to go about gift giving. Now, a couple ways to get around getting someone a secondhand gift without making it feel like a secondhand gift is if you do a lot of your shopping through Amazon, there is an option to buy a used version of whatever. So say for example, your sister wants a orange juice, like juicer. There are some companies that will have a used version of a juicer, and all it is just like if you're going to the store and the box had already been opened and sent back, that's what you're getting. So it says used, but then you're still kind of helping out in that sense. It's a little bit more sustainable of a version that way. Another thing to think about is eBay. So if you have a family member that is a sports enthusiast and they really like a specific team, maybe you can get a collectible item on eBay, and technically that's used. And there's other things like that that you can think about when you get on eBay that don't really seem secondhand or used in the traditional sense. Now, if you have a family member or a friend that does not want a used gift, is not a fan of secondhand, doesn't want anything to do with that, then if they request an item that is like a general item, not necessarily a brand name item, then always research ahead of time and try to get the most sustainable version of that item. So, for example, if your sister says that she needs some new dishcloths for her kitchen, then you can do some research on different companies that make, you know, recycled fabric dishcloths or something like that. And then that way, what could have just been a quick buy online or in the store, you're doing a little bit more research and finding a gift that is a little bit more sustainable for a loved one. Now, if they do want a specific brand name item, you can always ask again if they would consider you doing some research on a sustainable version of that item. Sometimes this is hard because when it comes to like electronics specifically, you want to make sure that, you know, if they are requesting an electronic, that the adaptability works. Granted, I don't know if there really is sustainable electronics, but you get what I mean. So you want to make sure that it obviously provides the same use for them, but maybe you'd be able to find it in a more sustainable version. And if you strike out on both of those, my other suggestion is just make sure that you're buying a quality item. So I've talked about this a little bit in the past, and kind of what I've been doing more so when I are unconsciously thinking about what I'm bringing into my home is buying a quality good versus a good that you may be able to find for a cheaper price or, you know, from a cheaper store. If you're getting a more quality item for a loved one, then it's going to last longer and it's more sustainable in that sense as well. And something that kind of goes along the lines with a quality item is, in my family, there's a couple different people that use Amazon wish lists or wish lists for different stores. So again, rather than disregarding the item that this person wants, it's better off to get them something, again, quality, but something that they'll actually use. So if they're requesting that item, they know that they're going to use it because that's the exact item that they're asking for. So that might be another way to go about it, is ask someone to make a wish list, because then you would have a good idea of exactly what they want. And then again, nothing's going to waste, instead of getting something like, oh, I think that you really might like this, and then have the risk of them not using it at all. Then you don't have to worry about that if you're, you know, picking something off of a wish list. Another idea, and this might be for specific people in your life that it would work better for than others, is especially if you know people who kind of have everything. There are some of those people that are hard to shop for. We all have one of those people in our lives. So one thing that might be nice is to provide a service or an experience versus an actual tangible good. So for example, you know, if you have someone in your life that just buy whatever they need when they need it, so you don't really have very many ideas of what to get them, but they work a lot. So maybe you want to get them a massage. And then that also helps potential local businesses, and, you know, it's a full circle type of thing. So, like, providing a massage versus, or a gift certificate for a massage versus getting them something that they are not going to use could be a great option as well. With, like, an experience, so, like, if you have, you know, an older niece or nephew or something that you're buying gifts for, you could consider taking them out to a park or some type of amusement park. Taking them out for lunch, something like that would be really nice too. And then that way it kind of gives you an excuse if you don't get to see them very often, or if you'd like to spend a little bit more quality time with that person, it's a great excuse to be able to provide a nice gift, but also spend some quality time there too. Along those same lines, you probably remember when you were a kid, or if you have children, a lot of times, I think this is maybe taught in schools a little bit too, but you would get coupon books for different services or goods around the house. So again, if somebody is like, I don't want anything for Christmas, you know, you being around is just enough, but you still want to get them something, again, you can always provide them, like, you know, here's a coupon for me cleaning your car one day, or helping me organize your kitchen utensils, or whatever is something that you know that they may not love to do. Like, I would love a coupon for someone doing my dishes, but my husband's pretty good at that, so I don't really need it. But if I didn't have my husband around for a while, I would definitely appreciate a coupon for doing dishes. So something like that that you could help out with. Maybe if you have, like, an elderly person that you're buying gifts for or that you're thinking about, you can give them a coupon for shoveling snow or raking leaves, or whatever might suit their life the best, and that isn't necessarily a tangible gift, but is a very thoughtful, kind gesture that would really help them out versus something that may not use. And lastly, when it comes to gift giving, is again, for those people that may not really need much or say they don't want anything or just have everything that they would already need, is you could consider making a donation in their name. So that's really helping out maybe a good cause. For example, in my experience in the past, I've given gifts that are, you know, potential, like adopting an animal from an animal sanctuary for a month, or, you know, you can donate to a food pantry in their name. You can donate so many other things. You can donate in the person's name if they've struggled with a certain illness in the past, or if they know somebody who has, then you can donate in that cause. There's obviously plenty of different options that you can choose from based on whatever fits that person. Okay, now, so when it comes to gift receiving, this is kind of a taboo topic to talk about, but again, you want to be prepared. Being prepared is one of, you know, I would say a pillar in sustainability, because then you're not wasting anything, time or money or items. So if you do get those requests like I do when it comes to, you know, what do you want for Christmas, make it clear if you are okay with getting secondhand items that you're okay with getting secondhand items. You may have to do, in my case, I have let my mom know that, and I let her know that I want this and this, and she already has it in her house, so she just gives it to me at the time, and I'm like, Mom, this is not the point. You're supposed to wrap it and like put it under the tree for Christmas. I don't need it right now. But a lot of people, like, if you need new salt and pepper shakers because yours aren't working, which is exactly what just happened in my case, some people probably have some old pepper, like salt and pepper shakers, even around their house. So like, even if you're, especially if you're speaking to someone who is frugal or, you know, who may not have a lot but wants to give you something, that's a great gift suggestion or gift request. Is, you know, if you have, you know, X kitchen utensil or whatever, if you have a spare of those, like, I would love to have one because I don't have one in my house, or whatever the case may be. So making it known that you accept secondhand gifts, but going along with the gift giving in the instance that someone doesn't want to go to a secondhand store and try to, you know, do that whole scavenger hunt to find you something that's secondhand that you want, then you can always ask them to just make sure that whatever you're getting is a sustainable version of whatever it is. And a lot of people, again, they may not be interested in doing the research. So if you, for example, for me, I would really like a new cutting board for Christmas. So if, you know, if I tell that to my mom and she doesn't know exactly what a sustainable material is, for example, then you can always say, well, you know, there's this brand and this brand or this material that you can use. So in my case, if I wanted a cutting board, hey, if it was like a bamboo cutting board, that would be appreciated, something like that. So you might have to do a little bit more research on your own end to then ask for or request that gift. And again, like when it comes to donations and charitable organizations, you can always ask for that as well. Let them know that, hey, I'm a really strong supporter of this specific animal sanctuary and I'd love to help them out, but I don't really need anything. I'd love it if you could make a donation to them in my name. You can always request services or goods instead of actual tangible items. You can make an Amazon list. All of those things that really go hand in hand with the gift giving part of things can obviously be implemented in how you are requesting gifts as well if you're asked. But the main thing about gift giving and gift receiving that of course goes hand in hand with the sustainable lifestyle in general is to make sure that you're prepared. So I have been writing down ideas, you know, if my mom says, oh, I really love this, I hate this thing in my kitchen, or I hate this thing in my laundry room, I really wish I could find something that would work better, you know, I'm making those notes, I'm making a list on my phone. I've been doing that for already a month or so, and I've been making those notes. So being as prepared as possible is definitely going to help out when it comes to gift giving, but also gift receiving. Start writing those things down for yourself so that when somebody does ask you, then you can let them know, you know, I really love this. So I hope this was helpful. Again, this is the first holiday that I'm really putting this at the forefront of my mind. So I'm these are just the ideas that I have and what I'm going through, how I'm going through the process. So like I said, if you have a suggestion on different things that you're doing or different ideas of how to gift give or gift receive, I'd love to hear them in the comments below. I'm also going to be doing a video in the future about gift wrapping and how to present or travel your gifts to the people that you're giving them to. So stay tuned for that. But as far as this video goes, that's all I have for you. If you haven't already subscribed, I would really appreciate if you did. And give me a thumbs up if you like this content. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.